Welcome to a lesson on insincere voting. In this lesson, we'll define insincere voting, provide an example of when insincere voting may occur, and finally introduce instant runoff voting, which is meant to address insincere voting. In an election, insincere voting, also called tactical voting or strategic voting, occurs when a voter supports a candidate other than his or her sincere preference for a strategic purpose or to prevent an undesirable outcome. This can occur when more than one candidate share somewhat similar points of view. Let's look at an example. Here are the election results of a student body presidential election where candidate A is a Republican, candidate B is a Democrat, and candidate C is an independent. For the purpose of an illustration, let's assume the Democrat and independent share common points of view on several issues. Because candidates B and C share common points of view, it is possible that some independents may vote Democrat just to avoid the Republican from winning. So by independents voting Democrat to avoid the Republican from winning, this is an example of insincere voting. Notice in this case, if we use the plurality method to determine the winner would be the Republican with a total of 358 first place votes, or approximately 42.1% of the first place votes. Notice how this win would not be a majority, but using the plurality method, the winner is candidate A, the Republican. Now before we discuss the instant runoff method, let's determine the Condorcet winner. To determine the Condorcet winner, we do a one-to-one comparison. So we determine the winner of A versus B, then B versus C, then A versus C. So for A versus B, we eliminate C. Notice how A would win in the first column, B wins here and here. So A versus B is 358 to 492, so B is preferred over A. Then for B versus C, we eliminate A. Notice B wins only here, C wins here and here. So B versus C is 278 to 572, C is preferred over B. And then finally, for A versus C, we eliminate B. So A wins in the first column, C wins here and here. So for A versus C, we have 358 to 492, C is preferred over A. So notice C is preferred over A and B, and therefore the Condorcet winner is candidate C, the independent. But now let's introduce the instant runoff method, which is meant to address insincere voting. Instant runoff voting, also called plurality with elimination, is a modification of the plurality method that attempts to address the issue of insincere voting. And here's how it works. In IRV, voting is done with preference ballots and a preference schedule is generated. The choice with the least first place votes is then eliminated from the election, and any votes for that candidate are redistributed to the voter's next choice. This continues until a choice has a majority or over 50% of the votes. So if a voter happens to vote for a candidate that gets the least first place votes, because those votes are transferred to their next choice, this eliminates the motivation for insincere voting. So if we go back to our previous example, let's determine the winner using the instant runoff method. Notice in this case, candidate C has the least first choice votes, and therefore using the instant runoff method, we would eliminate candidate C. By doing this, we would assign these 214 votes to candidate B. But notice how by using this method, there's no incentive for the independents to vote for the Democrat just so the Republican would lose, because they know if their candidate is eliminated, their votes will be assigned to their second choice. So if we eliminate candidate C, notice how the Republicans still have 358 votes, but now the Democrats have 214 plus 278 votes, which gives them approximately 57.9% of the votes, and therefore a majority, and therefore candidate B is the winner using the instant runoff method. But notice at the same time we've discovered one of the issues with the instant runoff method. It is possible for the winner of the instant runoff method to violate the Condorcet criterion, because remember the Condorcet winner was candidate C, who was eliminated using the instant runoff method. We'll take a look at the insert runoff method in more detail in the next lesson. I hope you found this helpful.